think they all went off.
Cheers, mate. Don't thank me yet. We need to see what we've done.
Righto.
In an attempt to break through impenetrable rock, the Bushmen have called in the help of explosives expert Brad O'Brien.
I've been working with explosives for 20 years.
Oh, look at that.
Gee,
that's a hole.
She certainly moved it. Years ago, I got diagnosed with cancer in the cheek. The doctors did say, you know, we might have to take your eyeball, but they saved my life. That's the main thing.
Yeah, look at that. The edge where the explosion hit, it softened up a little bit, but I still got all this hard stuff behind here, Brad.
Mate, we can take care of that. I think I might nearly have enough left over. We can put three holes and pop that clean off. And we're going to have to get a wriggle on. I've got other work I've got to go do.
Yeah, I know, mate. Yeah, I know. We didn't quite shift all of this, but if you see up here, we've got seam just there where it should be.
Yep.
That sort of stuff can make colour.
Brad will use his 55-kilogram pneumatic drill with a 1.8-metre long bit to punch holes in the wall for a second set of explosives.
This drill uses percussion and rotation, but overall you need the water. You've got to have water to wash the rock out of the hole, or else it just builds up and then you're stuck and you can't turn it. No water. What the? Something's going on there.
The whole reason I got Brad here was that's like our last chance. If we can't get the water sorted, we can't drill. We may as well not bloody be here.
It's absolutely desperate at the moment. 90 grand's worth of machinery sitting up there, and we can't dig the ground.
The Bushmen have gambled all their savings on new equipment and an almost impenetrable claim. To find Opal, they'll need to blast through undiggable rock on the north side of the mine.
Is it coming out that hose? Not really.
Nah.
You got prostate problems, that hose.
But a lack of water pressure for their pneumatic drill is stopping them from using explosives.
I need that bubble up here. Below there, not enough water. So Les has gone to get the pump. If he can put a pump in the line somewhere to give us greater pressure, we're up.
I put a pump on it to get the water down to the drill. So hopefully now it all should work properly. Hopefully.
Yes,
we have.
That looks better. Righto.
Still gonna bloody do it.
Hard work, that drill. Very heavy, dirty. Oil flowing everywhere, water.
Drill's pretty hard. Mate, this is like, I don't know, trying to open a coconut with a dining knife.
We're on our last set of holes now, and we're ready to blow. All right, let's get cracking on. Let's blow this bugger up.
At $36 per bomb, this second blast will push the total to nearly $1,000.
Mate, that's the last of it. That's the last of it. So even if I had time, I've got no more material to work with.
Okay. We all ready?
Yep.
All right, let's send her.
Poor old Rod, he's getting a bit stressed because if we don't find any money, he's borrowed a lot. When we get down there, we'll see whether we've made any money or just lost all our money altogether.
It's truth.
Wow, that's just what we wanted, Brad. Let's see if there's any opal in here, boys. I tell you what, I'm not saying too much. Jesus, there's nothing here, Les. I can't see anything, can you?
No, I can't see anything.
You're kidding, there's no colour in that.
I'm thinking it's been blown out.
There's a bit there. Look at that.
Oh, gee, look what I got here. Nice piece of rock.
Oh, hello.
Oh, well, you got another piece here.
I got a bit too, Les.
Hey, hang on, I found a bit too.
Oh, beautiful red there.
What'd you get? Oh, look at...
Look at the colour in the bloody...
See the way it shattered from the blast? Ha ha, Les!
Well done, mate.
We've done it!
We might be going well.
There's going to be more here. We find that sitting on the salt, that's not there at all they're going to be.
Oh, it's got to be a bit more than that, yeah.
Oh!
Have a look at that.
That's a gem.
All right, let's have a bit of a gander at this and see what we reckon it's worth, eh?
We've invested an awful lot of money this year. We need to have a lot of money come back in.
There's a new buyer coming out today, isn't there?
Yeah. You know young Benny?
Yeah.
I have arranged for a buyer to come out and have a look. Young bloke Benny. He's only been around a little while, but he's very good at this internet selling.
Hey, boys.
Hey, Benny, how are you, mate?
Good, mate. Yourself?
Yeah, not too bad.
So, what have we got today?
Have a bow peep at that.
I was selling and trading opal in Sydney for about a year. Decided to make the move up to Lightning Ridge with the family. Opal was something that just grabbed me and decided to go from part-time doing it to make it a full-time thing.
Well, there's definitely some nice stones here, mate. OK, hit me with it. Where are we at?
20 grand, and that's cheap as.
The Bushmen have Grauen black seam opal. It displays the full array of colours. And it's in the rough.
There are definitely some nice stones here.
Of course there are.
20 is probably a little bit more than I was willing to pay. But there is a but. I'm happy to do 20 on a couple of conditions.
Uh-huh.
You know I'm very good at selling opal.
Yeah.
So how about I'll meet you on 20, you show me how to mine it, and I get to sell your opal for you. And you know, mate, with me selling it for you, you are going to get a better price for it.
If you can give us a minute to have a yarn to each other,
mate. No worries, mate. Be a great opportunity to mine with the boys. If I can get out there and learn off the best, well, it's going to benefit me as well. And I think selling opal for them is going to benefit them.
I know, mate. Well, I'll tell you what we come up with, Ben.
Righto, hit me.
You can't just come into the crew now and go straight underground. But what we can say, we've got a drill and we need a driller. If you're prepared and run the drill, we'll certainly let you sell the opal. If we all get along and everything's going all right, we'll sit down and have a serious talk of you coming into the crew.
Okay. I'm definitely happy with that. If you guys are on board with it, I'd love the shot at it.
Thanks, Les. Thanks, Todd.
There you go, Benny.
Ready.
Thanks, boys, and I'll see you Monday morning.
You bet you will.
Not a problem.
It can't just be me and Les anymore, you know? We're both too old. So you've got to sort of expand things and get bigger and bring some young blokes in.
It's been a great end to the week to find a bit of colour so we can go shopping and buy some more supplies.
Yeah, it's a big investment. I reckon it's going to pay off for us. This is going to be our year.
Yeah, the Bushmen expanding a little bit. Got about 20 grand for, so that's going to help us out.
Cheers, fellas. What a bloody start.